Hi, I'm Mike from Hummingbot, and this video is to show the new scripts component that we just released in version 1.4. So the new scripts component is designed to allow people to prototype trading strategies much more easily than before. Our old strategies used to require you to create Python-based files, configuration templates, and a lot of boilerplate, which a lot of developers just don't want to use when you're prototyping a new something brand new. So with scripts, you're writing pure Python. You have all the access to the normal kind of like power of Hummingbot connectors, but you can kind of create the automated bots in just a few lines of Python code. So we've created a few examples to show you how they work. So I'm going to walk you through those examples today. So in Hummingbot, if you pull up Hummingbot, you can run a script with start --script. And then we have a couple examples here. So before we run to them, let's dive into the code and see what they actually do, starting with dcaExample.py. So over here is a code for that script. And basically this is it's like a hello world type example that shows you how to launch a bot that just issues buy orders every tick for a fixed dollar amount. So this is just a demo strategy to show probably the simplest possible trading bot you can make, which is just something that automates a series of trades every interval. So the market, the trading pair we've chosen is the Binance to Tether market on Binance paper trade. So this allows us to just test something without risking real capital. And we're going to do an interval every 10 seconds and then issue a buy order for $100, 100 basically UST in that market. So so you can see here that this is really all the code right here that exists for the script. What it's really doing is it's going to define these variables, and then every tick, which is 1 second by default in Hummingbot, it will basically issue that limit order for 100 USDT in this trading pair. And what we've done here is overridden some of the helper methods in Hummingbot. So there's a bunch of methods like did create buy order, did create sell order, did fill order that basically are called when that event happens. So now we've used a logger to basically create log messages whenever those events have occurred. So so that's it. So let's start the bot and see what it does. So here it's connecting to Binance paper trade, and now you can see it's created the buy order, and then every interval it's going to keep on creating that buy order every 10 seconds, and it will just do that until it's called. And so notice that all these messages are the ones that correspond to these messages here. So let's stop the bot, and obviously this is something you can edit. So let's change some of the aspects around this bot. Let's change this to ETH USDT. Let's change this to maybe 20, dollars, and then I should also make sure to change ETH here and here. Okay. I'll save the bot. I think for now you still have to exit the bot, exit the Hummingbot, and restart again in order to pick up those changes. So now let's try starting that script again, and let's see if the changes were in fact picked up. And it looks like they were. So now we're placing orders in the ETH USDT market instead of the Binance ETH USDT market. This actually might be a bug we have to fix on our side with Binance paper trade, because I do seem to have the balance available, but it's still canceling my trades anyway. This is probably an issue with the using the Binance paper trade connector with the script. As you can see, this is still very much a new feature. But I think from that, you can see the general gist of how the script works. So let's move on to a slightly more complex example and do more with what's available under the hood in Hummingbot. So the second example we have here is the buy dip example. And as an FYI, you can find all of these in the scripts folder in the Hummingbot directory. So we have a bunch of examples. And any script example you put in there, in that scripts folder, will be accessible after you type start dash dash script. So this by dip example, the way we would say dash dash script by dip example. But again, let's walk through the code before we understand how it works. So this one is a bit more complex. This is gonna buy Ethereum, using in the ETH BTC market, but only issue that buy order when the price drops 5% below the 50-day moving average of a previous candle. So basically what we're gonna learn here is not just how to issue orders and trades, but how to listen for data from the exchange order book and to only issue that command when something happens. In addition, we're also gonna learn how to use the rate oracle feature in Hummingbot, which converts from one price, one token, to another price using some type of price feed. So, and the way we use it here is we're gonna decide how much you wanna buy in dollars, and then use the rate oracle to figure out how much that amount is in Bitcoin, so we know how to issue that trade. So let's walk through the code a bit before we dive in to the actual script itself. So similarly to the DC example, the onTick function is really where everything happens. And so this is basically called every single tick of Hummingbot. And what it's gonna do is it's gonna create a proposal and then it's gonna essentially execute the proposal. So this is very similar to how the peer market making strategy and other more complex market making strategy coming out work. So it's a good precursor to build up to those more complex strategies. But basically the proposals are basically the essentially will be created in case something happens. So let's essentially, it's gonna call this create proposal function. And this create proposal function will essentially fetch the daily, this data, and then calculate something. So first let's look at what this daily get daily close list function is doing. So this function here is what fetches the actual data from miners. So it's calling this URL and it's passing in these parameters and it's gonna receive the results of that response and essentially store it into some type of data structure. So, and then when this data structure, when it kind of evaluates, now you can calculate the average of the daily closes. And then if the current price is kind of below that sort of like the average of the last 50 closes, only then does a new order get added to the proposal. So, and so you can imagine what happens is every single second, every single tick, it's gonna go fetch this data from the Binance API, calculate if this is below the dip, and if so, it will add a new candidate. So if there is no order candidate, this proposal's list is empty, but if one is evaluated, then one is created, and then one, and then finally, it's gonna execute this proposal here. The other important function here is this one here, this budget checker adjust candidates. So this is going to essentially kind of like do some other actions and just make sure that you have budget to execute the proposal. But if so, it will actually then execute the trade. So that's really the script. So let's run it and see what happens. Okay, so now it looks like it did actually create the buy order, and it created this order over here. So that's just a really simple intro into scripts. So you can see how it works. But overall, I think we've created these examples not as examples that really are super useful, but more as starter templates that allows you to build upon them and to build whatever trading bots you want to build, whether it's for arbitrage, to provide liquidity or market make, or even just move assets from one place to another and to automate that process without having to spend a lot of time manually interacting with APIs or with the blockchain itself. So